Welcome everybody, this is Sebastian with another Jurassic Park unboxing video. Today I'm gonna unbox the Velociraptors in the Kitchen diorama made by Iron Studios. It's an art scale, so it's 1/10 scale, so it's the same as the John Hammond we recently unboxed, and the Ian and Alan that are up there, if you can see them. Can you see them? No, they're a little bit out of frame, but they're there, believe me. I'm gonna do it like from this point of view. I'm not gonna change the camera angle because it's quite a big box, so I don't have a way to hang the camera up to give you a good view. So I'm gonna just do it like this. It's the first time I've opened it, so I'm gonna be as surprised about what I'm gonna see in there. I'm really looking forward to this one because it's probably a beautiful thing. If you can see it, it's a really dark picture on the back, but we have here a piece of the kitchen with all this kitchenware, and we have the raptor on top of it, and the other raptor one raptor on top and the other raptor behind it, and a really scared Tim Murphy over there. So I'm gonna start with the unboxing, and we're gonna see what we're gonna find in there. And while I'm doing this, I'm gonna tell you that this is a video not for children. This is for adult collectors. So if you are a kid, please don't watch this, because I'm gonna mark it as not for children, and YouTube has recently become a little bit more difficult with their rules. And there we go, I'm gonna put this out of the picture. And here we have the styrofoam outer box, and I see there's a hole in here, but that's not something to be concerned about. It says top on this side, so I'm gonna cut open the tape, and I think it's gonna be some assembly required. I think most of the parts will be separate, and you just have to slide them in the base. But I don't know in what extent, so we're gonna see what we're gonna see. A little bit over there, yeah. And let's just for a moment remember this fucking great scene in the movie. Again, pardon my French, but that's so to make sure that this is intended for mature audience and not for children. Because I don't like to get fined because I said it's not for children and YouTube think it's for children. So that's why I'm gonna swear. Well, here we are. I'm gonna lift the top off. And there we are. There's nothing on this side, just a little two pieces of protection. I'm gonna put this down here too. And well, I'm gonna take the other camera and make some close-ups. We have a raptor over here, another one over there. We have Timmy in there, or maybe in here. No, here's a piece of the kitchen. Here's a piece of the kitchen. This is the base. And this is probably, a lot of kitchen stuff. Well, there's a lot in here, as you can see, a lot of different parts, and I read it in the on the website that it said loose kitchen stuff, and they weren't lying. These are all separate pieces, so that's great. So you can really make the scene like you want it. Where are we gonna start? I'm probably gonna start from the bottom up, so that means that I'm gonna start with the base first. And it's a limited edition, and I have number 318 out of 600. It's right there on the bottom. It's a really weird feel, and I don't know, I think this is a little bit of a mistake, because I see some strange shapes in here, like the paint wasn't completely dry when they put it in the package, something like that. This could be styrofoam, this could be the paper. So if that's the case, then it's a bit of a shame, but it isn't too big of a problem, but it's not something that should have happened, if I'm honest. Okay, well, got that out of the way. We got the logo in the front here, and I hope that a lot of stuff will be on top of the ugly parts, but it's a bit of a shame. But I'm not gonna let myself be disappointed by that too much, because I think it's gonna be a great diorama. If I can get this out of here. Yes. There we have the first piece of the kitchen. Looks really nice. And I'm gonna remove my ring because I'm afraid I'm gonna scratch something. And that would be unforgivable, of course. This is just standing there loosely, so I fear that that's gonna cause some trouble with people when they pick it up and something moves. Would have expected it to be anchored to the base, but I'm probably wrong. And here is the other part of the kitchen. And this is just a closed box with a hole inside to let the air out. The little hooks for the ladles and stuff like that. And it's gonna be connected like this, I think. Something like this. There is no instruction. They could have included a little booklet where what should go where, but probably not necessary, probably, but it would have been useful, I think. Okay, then we're going to go to the, let me see, this was over here, this was over here, to the first raptor. And I'm thinking that I'm really gonna love this. Yeah, this is fantastic. Wow, this is what I love. Look at the thing, it's fantastic. The detail on the face, the little teeth in there, the tongue that's sticking out, because it's gonna move the ladle that fell to the ground. It's fantastic, it's beautiful. This is better than I had expected. I'm gonna put it where it's supposed to be, and I'm gonna make some close-up shots later on, so you can see all the magnificent detail of it. And then we're gonna go to the second raptor. That's the one that's on top of the kitchen. And that's also fantastic. I mean, you can really see the texture, the muscles underneath. This is really great. Yeah. Okay, that's going over there. And of course, that's the one that... Is that the one that's looking at Lex when she starts banging with something, with another ladle on the ground? Or is it this one? That's this one that walks around, and then at the moment it's about to see Lex, it looks like that. So that's a different one. This is looking... that way for some other reason. I should have watched the scene before I got to the unboxing, but I was too anxious to get started and see what it was like. And here we have the little scared boy. He looks weird. I mean, and he's made of plastic. I would have expected him to be made of polystone like the other art scale statues, but he's really light. And he looks weird. He has like two vampire teeth. I'll show you in close-up. And he... His hair is too blonde? No, I'm not liking him here, no. I think the rest of the statue is fantastic. Looks really great, but Timmy isn't... something wrong about him. I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna remove this box. Alright. Need to make space here because I'm really sandwiched in here. I'm gonna put it over there. And we're gonna see what's in here. And this is something I'm also really looking forward to. I mean, they could have made it all in one piece and just put it stuck together there, but now you can really make it the way you like it, so that's great. And everything is separately packed, and as you can see, it's a really nice, what is it, an oven tray or something, I don't know the word for that. And as I can see like this, there are a couple of the same, because they're probably stacked in there. And they're a lot of the same. And then we have a bigger one. We have, let me see, we have 13 of these smaller ones. Then we have one bigger one, that's this one. and it's really nice high shiny silver, so it really looks like the real thing. And then we have a little pan, and we have three of those. We have a little smaller frying pan, is one of those. And then we have, there's two of those. And then we have some tops for this one. There it is. And there's two more to go with those two. And then we have another bag, and that has the utensils in there. And they're all made of plastic, by the way, but they look and they feel good, like the real thing. And these are supposed to go here. Yeah, that looks fantastic. I'm gonna look up the pictures from the original movie to see in which order they appear. But there's the different ones, and here's the big ladle. That's the one that's gonna be on the ground here. And three spoons and two other thingies, and we have something that's backed up here, and I don't know what that is. Yeah, show me. I think a knife, maybe. Oh, it's one of those barbecue skewers, or whatever you call that. I wouldn't even know the word of it in Dutch, so forgive me that I don't know that. And here we have something completely different. We have white plates, a whole stack of them. I don't know, they're probably like 10 or something. And that's probably gonna be the same for this little bundle. Yes, it is. They're the same. Yeah, the same plates, and they're all separately packed. So there's a piece of paper between every plate so that they won't damage. And here is the soup plates. They're a little bit deeper than the other ones. And there are probably 5 or 6 of those. And there are maybe 20 in total of this. Fantastic, it looks great. I'm gonna put it all together, and I'm gonna come back and give you some good shots so you can see what it all looks like. Well, here it is, all put together. I counted 58 pieces of kitchenware. And yeah, my conclusion, I think it's a great piece overall, and the highlight are definitely the velociraptors. I mean, the detail on them and the expression is great, is fantastic. The bad points for me are really Timmy. I mean, he looks nice, and he has the scarves around his hand and the blood coming from his ear, a lot of blood in that case. Those are great details, but the face is like weird. He has these two little white painted vampire teeth, so that's not really doing it for me. Like I said, the shiny paint on the base was a bit smudged, like it was put in the package too soon. So that's a shame. I mean, it's not going to distract from a great piece, but it is a detail that should not happen, a mistake that should not happen. And what I don't like about it, while I'm bitching, I might as well go on, is that the base is sloped to a smaller bottom of the base. So it makes it look a little bit top heavy. I would have liked if it was maybe straight or with the rocks, it doesn't matter, and it would have gone out so that it felt more solid, more secure, more grounded or something. And that's another problem that I'm seeing for this thing. It's really something you should put behind glass in a secure case, because one move and stuff can fall. I mean, this can all just walk around. So it's really something to look at, and don't try to pick it up like this, because I'm gonna predict trouble, and you don't want a statue that costs hundreds of euros or dollars to fall and break. So I'm really happy with it. It's a fantastic thing, and it's sold out at the moment, so I don't think you can buy it, but maybe you can find it somewhere. And if you do, then I'm gonna hope you enjoy it as much as I will. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.